Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the annual general meeting of Derby City Council. It's a great pleasure to see you all here today as we gather to elect the mayor for 2023-24 and determine important political matters relating to the administration of the council. The role of the mayor of Derby dates back to 1638. Although the powers and duties of the mayor have changed significantly since then, whoever is elected today will take over a position that is rooted in our city's proud heritage. The mayor-making ceremony honours the rich tradition and many esteemed individuals who have held the position before. Today we recognise the contribution they have made to Derby and the legacy they have left behind, as well as looking forward to the year ahead. It's been the greatest privilege to serve three terms as Mayor of Derby and to end my career as a local councillor. With two successive terms of office, I'd like to wish my successor the very best and hope that you get the same enjoyment from the role that I have. Before we proceed, I'd like to offer a warm welcome to our invited dignitaries who have joined us in the council chamber this morning. His Majesty's Lord Lieutenant for Derbyshire, Mrs. Elizabeth Fothergill, CBE, the Dean of Derby, the Very Reverend Peter Robinson, the High Sheriff, Mrs. Teresa Peltier, is that right? Peltier, the High Sheriff of Derbyshire, and the Mayor's Consort, Mr. Andy Flint. I'm delighted that you've found time in your busy schedules to join us for this important and historic civic occasion. I'm also very pleased to welcome new and returning councillors. Following the elections in May, congratulations to all 51 of you councillors, but especially to the 14 of you who have been elected for the very first time. I began my career in this council chamber in 1979. I wonder how many of you will be here in 44 years in 2067. But perhaps most importantly of all, I'd like to welcome residents of Derby who have joined us in the public gallery or who are watching online. It's great to have you with us. It's now my pleasure to request nominations for the position of Mayor of the City of Derby for the forthcoming municipal year. Sir.
Councillor Balbiasandu.
Councillor Balbiasandu, is that seconded? Councillor Howdill, thank you. Any other nominations?
Councillor Alan Graves.
Councillor Alan Graves, is that seconded? Thank you. Any other nominations? So it is a contested election, and I'm going to hand that over to Alex to conduct the ballot.
Any speeches?
Yeah. All right, before we vote, yeah. Councillor Shankar, you spoke first, so would you like to move?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Honorary guests, fellow councillors, it's an absolute privilege for me, and indeed an honour, to be nominating my colleague and my friend, Councillor Balbiasandu, for the position of Mayor for the forthcoming municipal year. As we all know, Balbia has served as our Deputy Mayor twice recently, a year predominantly dominated by COVID lockdowns and various restrictions, and again this last year supporting you, Councillor Wood, as the during your third term as Mayor. I'd also like to point out at this stage, Mr. Mayor, following negotiations last year when you took the position for the third time and Balbia was supported by councillors from the Labour Group and the Conservative Group, an agreement was then reached with the current leader of the council for reciprocal support to ensure the Deputy Mayor becomes the Mayor this year, and that was agreed, and I spoke about that during AGM last year. Balbia was born on the 1st of May 1958 in the Punjab, which is in northern India, to parents Jain Singh and Mahinder Kaur. He was one of two children and his sister Sukhvinder Kaur. Balbia studied at Rudgar Kalan High Secondary School, and perhaps as a sign of things to come, was school student union president in 1975 for a year. He's played various sports throughout his life, kabaddi being one of his more popular and active sports. Balbir runs various kabaddi tournaments and supports various committees to stage tournaments here in the UK even now. He came to the UK in 1976, where he immediately enrolled at Will Morton College, now Derby College, as well as taking on a job at Shaw's Metal, used to be on Ascot Drive, where he worked before he took on a role at Sir Francis Lee's on Colombo Street. He met and married his wife, Jaswinder, in 1979. The registration ceremony took place on the 16th of June, and on the 24th, the pair celebrated their marriage in a religious ceremony called the Anandgaj here in Derby. As well as running a local business and being well-respected, a well-respected community champion, Balbir is very much a family man. Balbir and Jaswinder have three blessed sons, Kuljit, Dipinder and Jatinder. Most of you will know that Balbir owns and runs a clothing manufacturing business in the heart of the community he represents. Set this business up in 1988, and it remains one of Derby's few clothing manufacturers left in our city. Alongside running his business, Balbir has dedicated much of his time tirelessly serving his community. He's been chair at the Indian Community Centre since 2003, chaired the Derby Race Equality Council since 2007, and was first elected to council in 2011. Balbir's time serving his community has been impressive. His huge efforts in supporting Derby during the COVID outbreak and the public health crisis has been unparalleled. He led the Sikh community's mobile langar service to support key workers and Derby's most vulnerable residents, providing them with hot, nutritious meals. Almost 50,000 meals were distributed to people across Derby and beyond. In addition to providing these meals, Balbir wanted to try and help with the dire PPE crisis at that time. And again, as one of Derby's only clothing manufacturing factories, he helped there as well. He heard from frontline staff just how they were struggling with the lack of equipment. So he set up a scrubs manufacturing line within his own factory. He raised over £100,000 within 24 hours to make sure these scrubs were delivered to the front line. Mr. Mayor, Balbir is a man of action. His actions through this crisis have helped literally thousands of people in our city and their families. His tireless dedication to public service and that of Derby is there for everyone to see. Irrespective of caste, colour or creed, Balbir will help everyone. I can think of no more befitting way to acknowledge Balbir's exceptional work than to make him Derby's first citizen and the mayor for the next municipal year. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Councillor Dinser, would you like to say something as a seconder?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I would like to endorse everything Councillor Shankar said about my friend and until recently my colleague councillor in Normanton Ward, Balbir Singh Sandhu. Nobody can be prouder of the dedication to duty he provided in the 2 years he's been Deputy Mayor to Councillor Frank Harwood in the first year and to you, Mr. Mayor, in this last year. And I know he has worked to support and complement the work that both of you have been doing for the people of Derby as first citizens. Therefore, it is only fitting that with such dedication and support, and with the promise and agreement of the Conservative group that they will reciprocate your request, Mr. Mayor, and the Conservative group, of allowing you to continue for a second year and Barbier to be deputy. And I think it's really important that that is remembered by everyone. But irrespective of that, I think his dutiful support cannot be underestimated and should not be forgotten. I know Balbir and his family as family friend for many years. My father and his father came to this country together and settled and have been contributing to the city of Derby for decades. We have followed our friendship into not only our council work, but as comrades, as local community workers. And there is no doubt that if you talk to anybody who has met Balbir Sandhu, that his community work in Derby, even before he became a councillor, was second to none. And many people will recount stories about how he has helped them even before he became a councillor. His charity work has been highlighted by Councillor Shankar, but that's only a small amount of what he does for people and helping them, whether it's financially or through support and getting them to get the help they need. 12 years we have worked as fellow councillors in Norton Ward, and I know no one who has worked more harder, more diligently, and more effectively in supporting his constituents, but not only that, the wider public of Derby. And if you go out into the Normanton area, if you ask anybody about Balbir Sandhu, they will tell a story about how he has helped. So it is only fitting and deserving that after doing his duty as deputy, that he is supported to become mayor of the city of Derby, the first citizen, an honour which I personally feel he deserves, and it should not continue to be thwarted. So I have no hesitation, but have pride in seconding Balbir Sandhu to be the next mayor of Derby City Council. Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor Dinser. Councillor Prosser.
So, thank you. The position of mayor, it's an office of privilege, trust and respect. A role to be earned through years of dedication, good service and impeccable public record. Elected by their peers, mayors should be made by friends and colleagues who appreciate a councillor's dedication and integrity. Over many, many decades, Alan Graves has shown himself worthy and proved his dedication. Loved by residents and fair in the chamber, Alan has not only focused on his role but trained and influenced councillors right across this floor, many of whom would not be here today without him, and count him as a friend and mentor. He is level-headed, articulate, driven and deserving, with few in the chamber today that could hold a candle to his record. And that's why I support Alan Graves as mayor. I would love to see these votes unwhipped and stripped of the political engineering that's so harmful in this chamber, so that the right mayor for the city, regardless of their political colour, is selected. While I may be asking too much of our broken system, let's raise our hands today for the honourable and deserving Alan Graves.
Thank you, Councillor Prosser. Councillor Evans.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I've known Alan Graves for 10 years now, and I know he first became a councillor in 95, I believe. He's worked tirelessly during that time for the betterment of Derby and the people of Derby, first and foremost, for truth and democracy, not for comradeship or sticking to what he's being told by somebody tapping him on the shoulder. Alan truly believes in doing what's right for people, He knows the systems, he knows how it works. He's helped so many people in Alveston, especially over the years. I have absolutely total faith in his ability to perform as mayor. And so I am delighted to be able to second that proposition. Thank you.
Thank you. Are there any other nominations? In which case, I'm going to ask Alex Huff to conduct the ballot. Are there 10 of you? Yes, I think there are. In which case, it's a recorded ballot. I'm still going to ask Alex Huff to conduct it.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. If you just bear with me one moment whilst I share my screen. Thank you, councillors. Councillors, when I read your name, will you please indicate whether you are for Councillor Sandu or for Councillor Graves in the election of the Mayor of the City of Derby for the forthcoming municipal year? So first of all, Councillor Amin, please. Apologies. Councillor Ashby, please.
Councillor
Sanders. Councillor Atwell, not in the room at the moment. Councillor Bolton, please. Councillor Bonser, please. Councillor Kerr, please. Councillor Chambers. Councillor Dinser. Councillor Evans.
Councillor
Eyre. Councillor Falk. Councillor Graves.
Graves.
Councillor Hassel.
Graves.
Councillor Heselgrave.
Councillor,
Councillor Alison Holmes. Councillor Matthew Holmes.
Yeah.
Councillor Hudson is absent.
Absent.
Councillor Senior Ingle, please.
Councillor
Phil Ingle.
Graves.
Councillor Corr, please. Thank you. Councillor Jangir Khan. Councillor Shiraz Khan. Councillor Kozlowski, please. Sorry, councillors, I'm having
Ingle,
a difficult time hearing.
Could I ask you to sit quietly, please, join the vote? Thank you.
Councillor Cuss, please. Councillor Lakin, please.
Councillor Graves.
Councillor Lindsay. Councillor Lonsdale is absent. Councillor Martin, please.
Councillor Sandu.
Councillor Morgan McGeehan. Councillor Mulhall. Councillor Nawaz. Councillor Onwaha. Councillor Pandey, please. Councillor Patterson. Councillor Pearce. Councillor Peatfield. Councillor Potter. Councillor Poulter. Councillor Prosser. Councillor Rawson. Councillor Repton, please. Councillor Ralston. Councillor Sandu. Councillor Shanker, please.
Councillor Sandu.
Councillor Smale. Councillor Swam. Councillor Truella. Councillor Whitby. Councillor Wilson. Councillor Cecile Wright. And Councillor John Wright. That completes the voting. By 24 votes to 23, Councillor Graves is elected as the Mayor of the City of Derby.
There'll now be a little break while this comes off me and goes on to somebody else. So, see you later.
Mr. Mayor. We'll wait till it's quiet. Mr. Mayor, could I ask for quiet in the chamber now, please? Mr. Mayor, I will now ask you to take the formal declaration of acceptance of offer, of office, apologies. If you can repeat after me. I, Alan Graves.
I, Alan Graves.
Having been elected.
Having been elected.
To the office of Mayor of the City of Derby.
To the office of Mayor of the City of Derby.
Declare that I.
Declare that I.
Take that office upon myself.
Take that office upon myself.
And will duly and faithfully.
And will duly and faithfully.
Fulfill the duties of it.
Fulfill the duties of it.
According to the best of my judgment and ability.
According to the best of my judgment and ability.
I affirm my commitment.
I affirm my commitment.
To corporate parenting.
To corporate parenting.
In respect of the City Council's children in care.
In respect of the City of Derby's children in care.
And will encourage others to do so.
And will encourage others to do so.
I pledge to take every opportunity.
I pledge to take every opportunity.
Presented to me.
Presented to me.
By virtue of my role as a councillor.
By virtue of my role as a councillor.
To promote the well-being of children in the care of the City Council.
To promote the well-being of children in care of the City Council.
I undertake to observe.
I undertake to observe.
The code as to the conduct.
Code as to the conduct.
Which is expected of the members of Derby City Council.
Which is expected of the members of the Derby City Council.
Congratulations, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you very much. Probably the emptiest I've ever seen it. I would like to thank my proposer and seconder for nominating me today. I would like to thank the Chamber for electing me as your Mayor. Being the Mayor is a privilege, and I am honoured to take up this role. I would like to thank Mr. Wood for his service to the City Council. The most important part of anyone's life is their family. My wife, Anne, has supported me wholeheartedly in my role as councillor since I was first elected in 1995. She has helped me in so many ways, none more so than keeping me my feet on the ground. This morning, Anne said to me, "I never knew you wanted to be the mayor." Until a few weeks ago, neither did I. I am very proud to have her by my side, and you being here means so much to me. I would also like to thank our three sons, and one is up there, and our four brilliant grandchildren for their support over the years and all they have done. They've done deliveries and they make us very proud. Welcome to my family and friends in the gallery and welcome to those watching online. I must thank the Reform councillors and team for all their support. They are a small but dedicated team, expanding all the time. They are certainly batting above their weight. I would like to thank the people of Alverston, Allenton, and Wilmorton for their continued support for voting for me. It is truly humbling. I appreciate that my election as mayor is controversial. However, political parties that engage in dirty electioneering should not expect other parties to just forget that nastiness when we come together in this chamber. The eagerness to become the largest party certainly reared an ugly political personality and is now coming back to bite you. Oh, sorry, they've gone. I'm not only honoured to be the mayor of the City of Derby, but I am honoured to be the first in a new era of four yearly elections and the very first Reform Mayor for the city. I want the people of Derby and the councillors in this chamber to know that I will truly be representative of the city and exert an air of fairness in the chamber. Some of you will know that over the years I have personally had suffered abuse in this chamber, and I am determined to eradicate any nastiness towards any member of the council. I hope I can set a new standard worthy of the council. I am also aware that I will be presiding over a large cohort of new councillors, probably the biggest changes the council has ever seen. Maybe somebody could check that out. Derby is special in so many ways. Our history is interesting. We have an interesting football team. We have world-leading businesses, and there is a huge amount of talent in our city. Derby stands out from other cities, and that we have been a hung council for many years, indicating that the people of Derby want a variety of voices to influence our future as councillors. We should recognise and embrace that. That variety gives hope to the people of Derby. Thank you. The next item on the agenda is the election of the Deputy Mayor. Can I take any nominations?
Councillor Jed Potter.
Sorry, who said that? Yeah, thank you. And do I have a seconder? Okay. Do I have any more nominations? Well, then I duly. Oh, sorry. Who wants to do a speech? You mean the nominees?
Would the mover like to make a speech? No, you please switch your mic.
Ready to go.
Thank you. Mr. Mayor, the first to call you, Mr. Mayor. And councillors, it's my pleasure to nominate Councillor Jed Potter for the position of Deputy Mayor. Councillor Potter has demonstrated exceptional people and leadership skills during his time on the council, strong dedication to public service, and a deep understanding of the needs and aspirations of our community. Councillor Potter has a strong track record of serving our city and his Alistair ward, and he represents, having worked tirelessly as a councillor, city councillor on several committees since 2016 and outside bodies. Add to that his recent successes with community engagement and charitable fundraising that has only served to strengthen the respect and admiration already felt by residents of the community, and it's clear that he has the community at heart. Some of you may know or may be able to tell right now that I'm not actually from Derby. I moved to Derby some time ago, and I can remember as clear as day the first thing I remember of city was I hadn't even unpacked the removal van, and along the street came this great big smile and a welcome, which was Jed's dog, Jensen, who was accompanied by Councillor Potter. And I'm pleased to say that since that moment in time, we've been good friends. And I'm also good friends with Councillor Potter. it took no time to notice that that wasn't just me. It became clear that everybody in Alistair seemed to know and be friendly or otherwise thankful to Jed for one reason or another. Everybody in town seems to have one of his business cards. I don't know how many thousands he's gone through, but everybody's got his phone number and everybody uses it with a welcome. So back to the matter at hand, Councillor Potter's suitability for the role of Deputy Mayor is clear for all to see. I know he'll be just as proud of the role and the city as we will of him, and I therefore wholeheartedly forward a nomination and urge members to support it. Thank you for your consideration.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Does the seconder want to speak, or are you happy to go to the vote? Yeah, sorry, sir. Okay, so can I have the vote to elect Jed Potter as the Deputy Mayor? It's unanimous. Thank you very much. Congratulations. Where's it gone? Congratulations, Councillor Potter. I look forward to working close with you over the next course of the year.
Mr. Deputy Mayor, I will now ask you to take the formal declaration of acceptance of office. If you can repeat after me. I, Jed Potter.
I, Jed Potter.
Having been elected.
Having been elected.
To the office of the Deputy Mayor of the City of Derby.
To the office of the Deputy Mayor of the City of Derby.
Declare that I.
Declare that I.
Take that office upon myself.
Take that office upon myself.
And will duly and faithfully.
And will duly and faithfully.
Fulfil the duties of it.
Fulfil the duties of it.
According to the best of my judgment and ability.
According to the best of my judgment and ability.
I undertake to observe.
I undertake to observe.
The code as to the conduct.
The code as to the conduct.
Which is expected of the members of Derby City Council.
Which is expected of the members of Derby City Council.
Thank you very much, Councillor Potter. Congratulations.
Thank you, everybody. Mr. Mayor, Madam Mayoress, very Reverend Dean of Derby, Lord Lieutenant, High Sheriff, members of the council, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Although having served as a deputy mayor before, I am still immensely proud to be nominated and elected to serve as Derby's deputy mayor again. Derby is in my DNA. My family being residents of Derby for several generations, well over 170 years. From humble beginnings to owners of businesses and property owners. No matter where I served and work, whether in the Merchant Navy, national police organisations or outside bodies, I was always known as Derby Jed and proud to be known as such. I sincerely hope that my position as Deputy Mayor, I will bring further an honour and pride to this city. Thank you for both nominating and electing me to this position. Thank you.
Right, thank you very much. Item three is to thank the retiring mayor. We will now move a motion of thanks to the retiring mayor as printed on the front of the agenda. Do I have a proposer and a seconder? Thank you, Councillor Poulter and Councillor Ralston. Do you want to make any speech? Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. For a change, I get the easiest role within this proceedings today because it's a very simple and very easy task for me to give support, the council's support and thanks to Robin Wood and his consort, Andy Flynn. As you will have seen from the photographs at the beginning of these proceedings, Robin absolutely carried out his duties for the council with zeal, impartiality, and ability. And if I had my way, Mr. Mayor, I would add the words style, panache, and common sense. I actually believe, really, really believe, that in the last 2 years, there's probably nobody who could have carried out the role that Councillor Wood has done in the manner that it was done. Having said that, I understand and know that Robin had some frustrations about the resources available to the mayor and the capacity of member services to deal with what was necessary. But even so, he carried out those every single duty, as you can see from the photographs, with style and panache. He always dressed for the role. He always looked smart. I actually do wish that he'd resized the hat that he was wearing most of the year, but I think he knew that, and it perched on the top of his head in very strange ways. Robin As already said, he was first elected in 1979. He stood as mayor of this city on three occasions, which I think is a first. Robin probably correct me on that. But each year he's done that, and his previous partner, Geoffrey Tillett, was mayor in 77, 78 as well. And Robin took a great part in that. There's nobody in this council that knows the business of the council and the city any better than Robin has. He'll be a great miss, particularly for my group, not least for his presidency of the group for a long period of time, his experience as past chairman of the association, and who knew that he was once chair of the board of visitors at Sudbury Prison. I didn't know that until I started to look the other day. And I'm sure he carried that role out equally well. He's represented Oakwood since 2007, I believe, and a little over before that, and you know, five decades of involvement with this council, and he can only be commended for that. I hope that in his retirement, I know he has many, many interests that will keep him occupied. I'm sure the bear cave might get more use than it has done in recent in recent years. Robin, you've been an absolute rock for my group, for this council, and for the role of mayor. Nobody could have carried it out as well as you have. And on behalf of myself and the council, I'd like to thank you and Andy, your consort, for all your efforts and the manner in which you've conducted yourself and helped the city of Derby over the years. Five decades. Thank you very much. If you'll indulge me, I did forget to ask Robin in the course of my speech if he was still prepared to do the spell checking and proofreading of everything that we do.
Okay, thank you. Do we have any more speakers? Can we move straight to the vote? All those in favour? Thank you very much. I now invite Robin to speak.
Mr. Mayor, Madam Mayoress, Deputy Mayor, Deputy Mayoress, Lord Lieutenant, Very Reverend Dean, distinguished guests, members of Council, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Mayor, I congratulate you on your election and hope that you will thoroughly enjoy holding office as our first citizen. Political differences aside, I know that you will rise to the many and varied challenges that your office will present. Can I let you into a secret? Like most politicians, I have long held an ambition, and you enabled me to fulfill it. Presented to Derby Corporation by a former mayor and leader, Alec Ling, JP, FCA, in 1954, and made of ebony with a silver inscription, my pent-up desire for decades was to be able to use the gavel for the purpose for which it was made. You gave me that opportunity, Mr. Mayor, and I'm extremely grateful. Thank you, Councillor Poulter, for your very kind words. Being Mayor of Derby is not just about wearing robes and an ancient chain, or even a big hat if you dare, or riding in CCH1, or chairing council meetings. It is all those things, plus so very much more. It's about getting to see firsthand the beating heart of our city. As those of you who have held the office in the past will know, it's only as mayor that you get to find out about all the Derby citizens and what they can do for each other. The vast number of worthy and innovative causes that exist only because of the voluntary efforts of genuinely good people. Their efforts have been exceptionally remarkable in the last few years, and it's wonderful that the more difficult times get economically for people, the more people are prepared to give their time, their skills, and their hard-earned money for those less fortunate. I'm aware that Derby Council has afforded me a record time in the mayoral role. 3 very different years, if you count my time as the then mayor's consort in 1977, 4 years. Longer than some councillors survived to represent their wards. If I were to reckon up the amount of time I've spent in this building physically or virtually via video link, it would probably exceed a decade of my life. I like to think my time has not been wasted. Whether it is arguments I have made in the planning committee that have enhanced the building environment, or Derby heritage that's with us because I spoke out in 44 years on the Conservation and Heritage Advisory Committee, or the prejudices I have worn down in the progress of equal opportunities, or incredible successes that I have been able to encourage in the fields of leisure and culture, or simply sticking my hand up in the air in this chamber when it was the right thing to do, popular or unpopular. I believe that I can look back with some pride in the city that I've made my home. These decades have flown, and someone who was once the baby of the chamber, it's wonderful to see new, eager, young people replacing us with the democratic mandate of, well, some of the people of Derby. We can all do well to remember that the majority of the electorate voted none of the above by not making the effort to put a simple mark on a ballot paper. Looking back, there have been many highlights in the last couple of years. One I will never forget is witnessing over 10,000 ordinary Derby folk on the march to save their beloved football team. Opening Moorway Sports Village gave me a real sense of achievement, and revisiting it last Sunday, a year on, I was delighted to learn that nearly 1 million people had passed through its doors in that short time. Or a trip to the Royal Naval Base at Faz Lane to board His Majesty's submarine Ambush, much of which depends on the mental and physical efforts of Rolls-Royce workers here in Rainsway in Derby. 2 visits to our twin city, Osnabrück, and both journeys by rail all the way, as befits the representative of the city of Great British Railways. A joyous day at Buckingham Palace Garden Party, and so many visits to street parties in Derby to celebrate first the Platinum Jubilee and recently the coronation. We have cut countless ribbons, planted innumerable trees, well, posed with a silver shovel anyway, and burst its celebratory bubbles. I've witnessed the graduation of thousands of Derby University students. We've attempted to revive the city's mayoral attendances at events up and down the county and to support the fine work that our great cathedral is doing in the cultural as much as the spiritual life of Derby. And everywhere Andy and I have been, we have been given a huge Derby welcome. Derby is a welcoming, diverse and peaceful city. It's been a joy as mayor to share the ceremonies in this chamber completing hundreds of new UK citizenships, and more importantly, learning their stories over tea and biscuits afterwards. Taking those who have worked at Derby Royal Hospital alone, it is important to ponder how bad our health service would be without the professional contributions of people not born in this country. Mr. Mayor, I've left a copy of my welcome speech for use in citizenship ceremonies in the drawer in your parlour, should you wish to use it. This is the 53rd Derby mayor making that I have attended. Every mayor is different, and I'm sure our new mayor will have his unique approach to the job. Today brings an end to my innings in Team Derby. There's much left undone. I never did get the historic clocks repaired in the parlour or the civic silver treasures polished, but that pales into insignificance when I recall the many jubilant and sobering occasions we have witnessed. No other mayor of Derby has experienced a jubilee, the death of one monarch, followed by the succession and coronation of another in a single year. All those events, and so many more during the last couple of years, it has been my privilege to work with His Majesty's Lord Lieutenant of Derbyshire, Mrs. Elizabeth Fothergill, CBE. Her dedication to duty and her personal friendship have been invaluable to me. I naturally record my thanks to all the staff that have made my terms of office possible. But one person who is not a member of staff has made our lives so very much more rewarding as our guide, comforter, chauffeur, attendant, and I'm proud to say friend, is Mick Arnott. Where are you? I know that his wife, Sue, is present today, and I would like to say a special thank you to her for tolerating the demanding hours of absence that his duties placed on their family life. Lastly, I must thank the one person who encouraged me all the way, who put up with being hurled far from his comfort zone on countless occasions. He wore the mayoress's chain handsomely on so many formal and less formal occasions, even on the dodgems in the pouring rain at Ilkeston Charter Fair. Good grief. I even got him to marry me in this council chamber. Your retiring mayor's consort, my loving husband, Andy Flint. It's all right, you won't have to make a speech. Goodbye, everybody, and thank you.
Okay, thank you. We go to item four. Which is the apologies. Are there any apologies, please? I'm sorry, but you're not down as the whip for the Labour group?
Yes, Councillor Kerr.
Oh, Councillor Kerr.
Ajit Atwal is absent. He had a key access issue and has rushed off to deal with it.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Item five is the appointment of the Pinder and Tenter for the ensuing year. The next item of business is to the appointment of the historic position of Pinder and Tenter, a role that dates to the 12th century relating to the impounding of stray animals and the preparation of wool. I will now move the motion as it is printed on the agenda to appoint the general manager of Derby Live, Mr. Robbie Kerr. Do I have a seconder? Thank you very much. Anybody want to speak? Good. Can I move to by a show of hands? All those in favour? Thank you. That's carried. Item six is now the adjournment, which almost brings us to the first part of our annual meeting to a close. Before we stand for the national anthem, I would like to take the opportunity to thank the children of St Martin's School, who prepared and served refreshments to councillors and invited guests prior to the mayor-making ceremony, as well as catering and employability learners from Derby Adult Learning Service who will be providing lunch. I will now move a motion to adjourn the meeting, and we will reconvene at 3 p.m. to consider the remaining items of business on the agenda. Do I have a seconder? Thank you very much. I now draw the meeting to a close. That's not on here.